Hello, friends. For the next 6 minutes, I want to talk to you about loving God and loving others. This is a series of topic that we'll be discussing the month of January, along with my co-pastors. They'll be bringing up these topics with the hope that if we can understand what it means to love God, that we can serve Him better, we can live for Him better, and we can be a good witness for Him. And hopefully that as we understand that, we can also be effective in loving others, in serving others, and pointing others to Him. So the topic of today's message is basically giving it all up for love, and as a way of showing our love for God. You know, in the Bible, Jesus was asked, what are the greatest commandments? And He says, love God and love your neighbor. I mean, it sounds simple, but loving God and loving our neighbors takes more than feeling. You know, it requires our action. It's kind of like the phrase I often hear, love in action. You know, God actually had put His love in action. You can actually see that from the book of Romans 5:8, where it says, but God demonstrates His own love for us in this, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. So God loves us. And the way that He can show us that He loves us, He gave us His Son to die on our behalf to pay for our sins. And the Bible used the word demonstrate. He showed to us. He put it into action. Another verse that you can look at is from John 3:16-17. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through Him. Right here on these verses, it actually shows in a simpler way how much God loves us. That God so loved the world, and the world is us, His people. Okay, and that He is willing to sacrifice His only Son as a requirement for the payment of our sins. So as you see here, we see God demonstrating to us or exemplifying for us what it means to truly put His love in action. In the same way, if we are to follow in His examples and His teachings, we need to find a way or ask ourselves, what do I need to do to demonstrate my love for God? What is it that I need to change in my life? What is it that I need to give up? What it is that I need to let go so that I can show God that I love Him, or that I can show my neighbors or my wife, my husband, my children, my family, my friends, that I love them. You see, God knew the cost of loving us. God gave it all for love. God showed us that loving us required more than feeling, more than saying, I love you. It required actions, regardless of sacrifice, regardless of the cost. You see, loving God and our neighbors requires our action. This is when loving God and our neighbors gets difficult at times. Some may say that this is when it gets costly. In the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2, verse 15, it says, do your best to present yourself to God as one approved, a worker who does not need to be ashamed and who correctly handles the word of truth. Here, in the word that I want you to understand is the word, do your best to present yourself. What that means is that when you are looking your life and when you're living your life from day to day, ask yourself, if I'm about to do this, or what I'm about to do, will this honor God? Will this please God? Is this within His teachings? Is this within what He expects from me as His follower? And if what you're about to do will be different from His teachings or against His teaching, then you know you're heading on the wrong path. Because the right path is, as the author of 2 Timothy says, do your best to present yourself to God. Okay, so when you do things in life, you gotta ask yourself, will this please God? Will this demonstrate to God my love for Him? In the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 22, it reads, flee the evil desires of youth and pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace, along with those who can call on the Lord out of a pure heart. The simple terms here is just flee the evil desires, but choose righteousness. So the outcome of one action, that leads to reaction. So if you decide to let go of unrighteousness, if you decide to walk away from evil desires. What you will walk into is righteousness. What you will pursue are righteousness. Behaviors that are right in the context of what God teaches. Behaviors that will honor Him and will reflect His true value, as we find in the Bible. Behaviors that will not offend Him, or He won't find sinful. So whatever it is that's going in your life, the question that you need to ask is this: am I doing a right thing in the sight of God? Am I doing a right thing in terms of what God teaches? And lastly, I want to encourage you that as you explore what it means for you to love God and what it means for you to love others, ask yourself, what costs would you have to know? What sacrifice would you have to give up? What are the things that you have to surrender under God's Lordship so that you can demonstrate your love for God, you can demonstrate your love for others? I hope you find this message helpful, and we'll see you next time.